Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In last video, we talked about functional sound card, NS1 Mini. And what I bring you guys today will absolutely stand in you. I was immediately attracted by its amazing performance after playing on. So this is the baby I'm talking about today, MT5 Powered Studio Monitor, Takstar's first generation studio monitor, tailored for recording, remixing, DFAT reached professional levels in studio. And let me break down on its appearance for you guys. From the front side, it features a 5.25-inch polypropylene woofer with a red internal ring circle, and above is a 1-inch cell dome. At the bottom is a Takstar's LED logo. It will light up when the monitor is running. Now let's move to the rear panel. You will see a couple groups of switch and button here. From right bottom corner is an IEC circuit, and then is an AC select switch. This allows users who come from different countries using different standard voltage. Keep going is a power switch. Now let's move up a little bit. At the middle is a vent tube. On the left side is an acoustic space switch and a high frequency selector switch and a volume knob. We'll go through the details about those different levels in later video. On the right side, you have the signal input, unbalanced XLR, balanced 1/4-inch TRS, and unbalanced RCA. So that's pretty much about the MT5 Powered Studio Monitor. For now, I will give a quick start to run the MT5 monitor and with some explanation that you should know. Turn the input volume up to the minimum position by counterclockwise. This can essentially avoid a huge current input when your monitor is powered on. Then is to plug the attached power cord into the AC outlet. And before this step, there's a couple things you can do. One is to make sure your power switch off. And trust me, this can really prevent your monitor from the damage by power surge, even if a small probability. Secondly, you can set your calibration switch to normal position, I mean the acoustic space switch on rear panel. This can really depend on how you locate it in your own studio. If you put your monitor away from wall and corner, you can switch to zero. If you put it against the wall, then it's better to switch to -2 dB position. And if you put it in the corner, you want to switch to -4 dB position to significantly reduce the low frequency output 4 dB to compensate for 1/4 of the space. And by the way, the similar switch above is to adjust your output type. Switch to -2 dB to reduce high frequency output if your sound too bright. And switch to 2 dB to boost if your sound too dark. And zero position for normal. Thirdly, go connecting your mixer, pre-arm or other audio equipment with monitor. And it turns out three input options as I mentioned earlier video, unbalanced XLR, balanced 1/4-inch TRS, and unbalanced RCA. Since the three interface circuits are all connected together, please don't connect multiple signals to the input circuit at the same time. And for your information, when the audio cable length is more than 6 meters, balanced audio cable can provide better noise rejection and is the preferred connection mask. So once you have done all these presets, once again, just like one up before again, those little things can unconsciously protect your monitor, and now you can turn on your monitor. And then, back to your audio source, turn on your mixer, CD player, DAW, whatever equipment you have. Finally, you can start enjoying recording, remixing, and all kinds of music by MT5 Powered Studio Monitor. Thank you.